In this video, we will review Control Center Console's policy authoring. We are going to focus on some high-level concepts that you must understand before you can start creating your first policies. When you create your first few policies, you will need to start with creating your different component types. Component types correspond to the different resource types and subject types that we are going to be using in this solution. Control Center provides three different subject types: users, hosts, and applications. Subjects are the doers of the actions, and these component types define what are the different attributes that we can collect from these doers of action. For example, right now, our solution is configured to collect the department and job function of a user, along with some predefined attributes. It is important for the policy author to know what the attributes are available for him or her before they start creating their policies. We have also prepared a resource type, which we call Policy Validator. We create one resource type for each enforcer that you are using in the solution. So for this particular resource type, which we call Policy Validator, this application is able to return to us the classification and which department a document belongs to. I can use these attributes later when I create my own components. After you've defined the different component types you will be using, we will need to create the different components. There are three different types of components: subject, resource, and action. Subject components are a logical grouping of the doers of the actions. So let's say, for example, we want to create a policy that would restrict access to financial documents. I would like to create policies that would say only people from the finance department should be able to open finance documents. In order for me to do that, I would need to create a component that would tell me who the finance users are. If I would go back to my user component type, I would know that I could use the department attribute to define what department the user is coming from. Knowing that, I could create my subject component for the finance department user by setting a condition stating that department attribute of the user must be finance. Now that I have defined my subject component, the next thing for me to do is define my resource component. So I'll need to know what are the things I'm trying to control. In the example I've mentioned earlier, I want to control access to finance documents. In creating a resource document, you will need to select what type of resource you are using, which in this case is Policy Validator. And then specify the criteria to determine that a file is a finance document. In this case, we can use the department attribute that we have previously defined in the Policy Validator component type. I will save the components and proceed with the creation of the policies. When you are just starting with creating your policies, I would suggest starting with a blanket deny policy. The blanket deny policy will deny access to all the documents you are trying to control for everyone. Then, we can make additional sub-policies to define exceptions as to who will be allowed. Let me show you how that works. The first policy I'm going to use is a top-level deny. So I'm going to say deny access to finance documents, and here I'm going to specify who will be denied access to the finance documents. For now, I'm simply going to deny everyone access to the finance documents. So the policy effect will be deny, and since I'm denying everyone, there is no need for me to write anything in the subject components. However, I would need to put the finance documents under the resource components. If I do not put anything in the resource component, then this would be a generic blanket deny, which will deny everything from being accessed by anyone. And I don't want that. I just want people to be denied access to the finance documents. Therefore, I'm going to put the finance documents component here. At this point, there is no other configuration that we need to put in our parent policy, so I'm just going to go ahead and save this one. Once I've saved it, I can go to the Hierarchy tab and create a sub-policy for this parent-level policy. You will see here that this particular policy that we are now defining has a parent policy deny access to finance documents. Now I want to allow access for finance users, so my parent level policy will be denying everyone access to the finance documents, and then I'm defining a sub-policy that will be allowing users from the finance department to access the finance documents. So in order for me to do that, the policy effect will have to be allow. And now I'm going to specify my finance users. And then I'm going to specify the finance documents. And click Save. So if I look at my policy hierarchy now, I just have a parent level policy that denies access to everyone from accessing finance documents. And then I have a child policy that allows access to finance users. And that's how you start creating your policies. This concludes our demo on policy authoring within the NextLabs Control Center console. Thank you.